Aliu. Ya. Well, good afternoon and assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh to everyone. And before I begin my lecture, I want to know your background. I'm not sure whether you are doing a PhD in statistics or in mathematics. I just want to know how many of you are doing PhD in statistics? No one. No one, yeah? Okay. So the second question is, do you have any background in statistics? Yeah, that's why I'm not sure, you know, I'm not sure how to conduct this lecture, yeah, whether to have it higher level or lower level. I'm not sure actually, yeah. So I, you know, I just decide to have kind of intermediate lecture. Okay. So I know that you are in mathematics and statistics, yeah? Only one person here in statistics. Alright, yeah. So I'm not sure whether you're interested to listen to my talk, yeah? Because this is kind of statistics, yeah? But this is not a research, yeah? This is not my research, yeah? This is just a lecture, yeah? A lecture.
Control L.
Oh yeah, yeah. Because cannot see. Because already old, eh? Cannot see. Mana dia punya tu?
Apa aku? Ya,
saya. Mana ni? Saya tak dapat dah. Mana tak dapat? Biasa. Okay. Today, I got nervous when Dr. Mahendra is around. Actually, Dr. Mahendra, how's your class this morning?
Okay.
Okay. So, everybody understood him?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not sure, you know. I'm not sure the levels of the students. Because
most of them have done one statistics course already.
Yeah.
So you have to be careful with that.
Yeah. So anyway, that's why I'm not sure. You know, I'm not sure how to conduct this. Yeah, to make it lower or you know higher or intermediate. So anyway, I'm not sure whether you have design analysis of experiment or not. So, well, here I just want to, before I begin, yeah, let me just mention that most research, yeah, most applied research, yeah, they are empirical. Most applied research like engineering, yeah, medicine, yeah, physics and others, yeah, those applied research are empirical and they make extensive use of experiment. Yeah, and for this kind of applied research, you are not applied research, you are all theory. Yeah, so those applied research usually to support their finding, they collect data, yeah? They collect data, analyze their data, and then analyze their data using statistical technique. And you say that at the end of the research, you have. Achieved the objective of your research, yeah, support by the statistical analysis, yeah. And this is where statistical analysis is play a very important role, yeah. So usually, these applied scientists, yeah, when they are not sure about some issue, they will collect data and then analyze the data using statistical technique, and then make your conclusion. Yeah, support your finding based on the statistical technique. Yeah, so here that's why I mentioned here that social science often relies on empirical validity where statistics can really deliver something. Yeah, so as I already mentioned, yeah, those applied scientists they use statistical technique, yeah, to quantify their uncertainty about some issues. Yeah, however. No statistical technique can be used to eliminate, yeah, to or explain all of the uncertainty in the world. You cannot use a statistical technique for that, yeah. And here, just to mention, statistical technique help policymakers make decision, yeah. It can help policymakers making decision correctly if you use correct statistical technique. Otherwise, it will be a disaster to a community or to a country. Yeah, this is very important to mention. Yeah? Now, since the topic of my talk is the design analysis of experiment, so it's, I would like to mention that there are a number of design analysis of experiment techniques, yeah, that is available to solve a particular problem. Yeah? But however, it is really important, yeah, to choose which is the most appropriate technique to analyze your data, yeah, in that, when using the design analysis of experiment problem. Yeah. So before I begin, yeah, before I discuss some design analysis of experiment, let me just introduce you to a problem. Okay. Let's say a researcher here would like to determine if student performance on computer programming for the final student, yeah, majoring in computer science, are same or not for four universities. Yeah, because we have, let's say, UCA, UCB, C and D. Yeah, you want to know whether their performance, their final year student performance, are the same or not in the computer programming. Okay, so what they do, let's say, the researcher, what they do, they select three final year students, yeah, majoring in computer science from each university, yeah, select one from second and so on, yeah, and they give the student with a programming test, yeah, and then you get at the end of the study, you get the score of this student, yeah. So we'll see here, yeah, the score of the student, yeah. This is data one, yeah, where the way that the researcher collect the data is select three students from each university. Yeah, I mean for the final year student majoring in computer science. And then you give a test. Yeah, give a test and record their scores at the end of the study. Yeah. So this is I'm not sure whether you know about analysis of variance table. Yeah, this is just an introduction, yeah. This is just an introduction where when you analyze your data at the end of the study, you will get the analysis of variance table where you want to test the hypothesis that the performance of the student, the final student in computer science in four universities are significantly different. Yeah? But here, Dr. Mahendran, I'm not sure whether the p-value you mentioned or not in the morning, yeah, this morning. Yeah. So when you analyze your data, well, this is I haven't touched on how to analyze the data. This is just an introduction. Yeah. Usually, introduction for me takes a long time. Yeah, before I can, so that you can understand first. Yeah. So at the end of the study, this is the p-value. The p-value to test the hypothesis that there are differences in the performance of these four students in four schools. Yeah. This p-value is large. Yeah. P-value is the probability, the exact probability of making type one error. You mentioned that this morning, yeah? Or the smallest significant level at which H0 is rejected. Yeah? So this p-value, large, consider large, because it is larger than the alpha value, 0.05, where usually you test your hypothesis at 0.05. Yeah? So meaning that, yeah, since p-value is large, meaning that there is no significant differences between the performance of these four universities, yeah? So, what's wrong with this, yeah? So actually, what's wrong with this? You have collect your data, you expect that there's a differences in the performance of these four universities, but what's wrong with this, yeah? The answer to this is that, yeah? There is, when you do this experiment, yeah? When you do this experiment, you select the three students from each university, yeah, but you do not take into consideration another factor that will affect the experimental result. What are the other factor? That is the student's IQ. Yeah? You do not take into consideration when you do this analysis. Yeah? I mean, when you do this experiment. Yeah? So this, another factor, yeah, that is the ability of the student that you do not measure. Yeah, when you do not measure this variability will go to the error term. Yeah, that will make, yeah, because, well, this is in general. I haven't talked about how to analyze your data. Yeah? Let's say, yeah, this just want to mention, yeah, how to get this F, later on I will mention. Yeah? To test this hypothesis, you will use F-statistic, that is mean square treatment, the variability which is due to the differences of the performance of four universities, and these are the, yeah. So, when the variability, yeah, what you consider only the variability which is due to the performance of the student in the four universities, you do not take into consideration another variability which is due to the student's IQ. So, yeah. So for this, yeah, this is just want to mention afterwards I explain, yeah, SSE, yeah. Yeah. So when to do the analysis of variance, first you have to partition the total variation in a set of data. Well, afterwards I will mention how to partition that into, this is for one analysis of variance, partition into two components, yeah. So what you measure only the variability which is due to the different university, yeah. But there's another variability which is due to the students. Yeah. This is another variability which is due to CGPA student. You do not measure, yeah. So all this will go to the error term, yeah. So it will go to the error term. Will make this error become large. When this error become large, this become large. The whole thing become small. That's the reason why you get the p-value which is small. Yeah. So in this, yeah, meaning that, yeah, what you have done here, you have used wrong design. Yeah. What you have used is the one-way analysis of variance technique instead of using two-way. Yeah. So since this is, yeah, since you have chosen the wrong design, then you have to redesign your experiment. Yeah, you really have to redesign your experiment so that what you do now, you select. Yeah, instead of just select three students from University A, you select at you select one student, yeah, from University A with CGPA below 2.5. See right there. Yeah, and 2.5, yeah, student, yeah, from University A, one student here, and so on. So if you do like this, if this is the way you collect your data, meaning that you have taken into consideration the variability which is due to another factor, that is the CGPA of the student. Yeah.
Question.
Yeah.
Before you decide that you're missing another variable, right? Mm. So what is the test that you conduct to make you realize that your original design is wrong? What test did you conduct to
make
you realize
yeah.
it's wrong?
That will be explained later. This is just an introduction. Afterwards, I will explain. Yeah, afterwards I will explain what test I am using or what. Yeah. So this is just an introduction. Yeah, just to introduce to you that if you choose the wrong design, then you don't get the conclusion as what you expected. Yeah. So now when you redesign your experiment, yeah, what you get now, yeah, with the same source, yeah, university, yeah, performance of student, and you include the ability of the student, then your p-value, yeah, will be small. Yeah? This will indicate that there is a significant differences between the performance of the four universities. Yeah? Alright? So this is just, I want to mention, yeah, the introduction to mention is very important to choose the correct design. Alright? Now, yeah? So this is another example that I want to mention. Yeah? Outliers in experimental design. Yeah? Even a single observation in experimental design can distort the entire analysis. So this is a paper, yeah, this, I have discussed in this paper, where this is my friend, and this is me, my friend, and this is my ex-boyfriend. Yeah? You know this, my ex-boyfriend, why I'm doing together with my ex-boyfriend? Yes, because he used to be my boyfriend, now he is my husband. So he is my ex-boyfriend. Yeah. So anyway, yeah. So if you look at this, yeah, so this is a data set, yeah, that you have obtained after doing the experiment. Yeah. Look, this all good data. Yeah. So this from let's say this is treatment A, B, and C. Yeah. Now, just by wrongly recorded, yeah, one observation, instead of recorded 144, you record as 744. This is an outlier. Yeah. So what happened? Look at the result of the analysis of variance table here. Without outlier, the p-value is small. But just with one this outlier, it will affect the result. So it's also very important. Yeah? When there's an outlier, you cannot just simply use the ordinary method, yeah? That is not robust. Okay? No. So we have seen. Yeah? We have seen an example. Yeah? Here I just to mention, if you run a program, any kind of data, yeah, we will definitely get output. And some of them may be statistically significant, but we have to apply our own judgment or logic before doing any analysis. Yeah? So, of course, when you collect your data, you want to analyze your data, you just use computers, and there's so many statistical packages now, you will get the answer. Yeah? Whether your output, yeah, is is reliable or not, depend on whether you have used the correct statistical technique. Yeah? Because you have to be sure that, yeah, you have to make sure that many researchers is not aware, yeah, that statistical package just follow the instruction by the researcher. If you say, I want to analyze using this design, the computer will do it for you. Yeah? The computer doesn't know whether you have chosen the correct design or not. So it's very important, yeah, because some researchers, not from the mathematics or statistics student, from others of social science, they are very proud. They say, I don't need any statistician because now I can analyze my data easily. Okay. Now, see here, just want to highlight here that, because we have seen a few examples. I've given you a few examples that indiscriminate use statistical technique often produce very confusing and misleading inferential statements. Yeah? So researchers will become very upset, and then he will say that he start to believe there are three kinds of lie: lie, then lie, and statistic. Okay? So this box stated that now it's really too easy. You can go to computer and with practically no knowledge of what you are doing, you can produce sense or nonsense, a truly astonishing way. Okay. So here, yeah, just to mention a few things. Just to mention here, statistical technique help policymakers making decisions. Yeah? And with the availability of statistical package, yeah, so many packages now, SPSS, SAS, Minitab, and so on, has driven more researchers to use statistical technique blindly. Yeah? And the conclusion of you will get reliable conclusion if you use appropriate statistical technique, diagnostic, model validation, remedial measure, and so on. Yeah? So this is just want to share with you some of the mistakes in statistics. Yeah? Some mistakes in some journal that have used statistics. There are so many here, yeah, that I come across. Yeah? So now comes the, that's all introduction. Yeah? So now comes to the explanation of what statistical design of scientific studies. Yeah? So this design of an experiment actually is a process. Yeah? Process of planning a scientific studies. Yeah? So researcher really have to plan your studies, whether it is experimental or observational. Yeah? With suitable design. So you have to plan your studies with suitable design. Yeah? The correct design, what I mean here, you have, before you collect your data, you really have to plan. Yeah? You plan with design so that you collect the correct data and you can analyze it using appropriate statistical method. Yeah? So if you do like all the correct step, then you will result in a valid and objective conclusion. Yeah? Objective of the scientific studies, yeah, is to determine. We want to determine the effect of the manipulated independent variable. Yeah? Independent variable on the response variable. Yeah? So we will manipulate a few independent variables depend on your research. Yeah? So we want to see what is the effect of this independent variable on the response variable. What is the response variable? The response variable is the variable that you will measure at the end of your study. At the end of the study, you will measure what you want, YIG usually. Yeah? So the basic goal will be to design studies in such a way that they lead to a simple, yeah? We want to design, we want to plan, yeah? also that they will lead to a simple, effective statistical analysis. Yeah? You do not design a study which is very complicated. Yeah? At the end of the study, you cannot find any design that is suitable for that kind of complicated studies. Yeah? So here, in this design studies, we will employ analysis of both variant model and also analysis of variant method in the analysis. Okay. So here, now I just want to mention, I give you some introduction first before I discuss the specific design. Yeah. So what is analysis of variant? Yeah. Analysis of variant is a technique. Yeah. When you collect your data, then you will get observation. Yeah. You collect your data, you do you conduct an experiment, then you will have data. Yeah. So when you have data, you can measure the variability. Yeah. So what we do here in the analysis of variance, you want to partition break down the total variation in a set of data into several components depending on the sources that will influence the experimental result. Yeah. So you have the total variability, and then you want to partition into several components. This is in general. Okay. So before you can understand some design that I want to discuss, you need to understand some of the important definition. Otherwise, you don't understand. Yeah? So first, we want to see what is a factor. Yeah? A factor is an independent variable of interest to be studied in an investigation. Yeah? So that is the independent variable of interest. Yeah? So example, you want to investigate the effect of price. That is the independent variable or the factor. The price on sales of particular item. Yeah? So that is the independent variable, the price. Yeah? On what? On sale. So sale will be the response variable. And say you want to analyze the effect of TV program. Yeah? You can have many TV programs, just to be specific, I just mentioned TV program, that is a factor. On the appeal of a woman's interest, let's say. Independent variable that you are of interest here. You want to analyze the effect of baking temperature, different temperature level, on the volume of the bread that you want to bake. Yeah? So you have different temperature level, you want to see the effect on the volume. Yeah? And say you want to analyze the effect of different vitamin C, on the prevention of cold. Let's say you collect 100 students, 100 patients, you give different types of vitamin C, and at the end of the study, perhaps 1 year, you will see how many times, how frequent that each of them catching cold. Okay, so that is what we mean by factor, right? And this factor, if I classify the factor into several components, then or several categories, each of them we call it treatment. There will be a factor, and then I classify into several categories. Each of them I call it treatment. Yeah. And here, another way of defining factor, a factor level or combination of factor levels applied to the experimental units. Yeah. So like here, you want to, as I already mentioned, you want to study the effect of types of fertilizer. Let's say type of fertilizer. Yeah, types of fertilizer on yield. On yield of a crop. Yeah. So meaning that this is a factor. Yeah. The independent variable of interest. Yeah. And For one factor study, because I'm only looking at one factor, for one factor study, the level of this factor is the treatment. Yeah? So the level here will be the treatment. Okay? Now, for more than one factor study, the factor levels combination will be the treatment. Yeah?
Here, I only consider one factor. Yeah? Let's say I want to study the effect of temperature level. Yeah? Temperature level. Levels and drying time. Let's say drying time. Yeah, drying time on what? Yeah? On solid lab. Yeah, on solid lab in a samples of yeast. Yeah, solid. Yeah, the weight of yeah, solid lab on weight lab. Yeah, solid lab on sample of samples of yeast. So here, what you do, you have two level, you consider two factors, temperature level
and drying time.
Yeah, there are two factors of your interest. Yeah, let's say temperature level, you have a three level here. Yeah, temperature level at 30, 31, 32, or 30, 35, 40 degrees. Yeah, and here drying time 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. Yeah, so in more than one factor study, the factor level combination will be the treatment. Yeah, so here, how many treatment do I have here for?
So we have 12 treatment.
So in general, if one level has A level, and one factor has A level, the other has B level, so we will have A, B treatment. Okay. Now, then we have to understand what is experimental units. Yeah? Experimental unit is any entity such as person, animal, yeah, object or anything that receive the treatment, or you will apply this treatment to that entity. Yeah, so that is the treatment. Yeah. So here, if you look at okay. So I just want to give you example so that you can try to answer whether what is the treatment, what is the experimental units. Yeah. So now let's say I want to study the effect of types of fertilizer on yield of a crop. Okay, what are the experimental units? What are the factors? Yeah. Let's say I want to study the effect of types of food, and on the weight increase. Yeah. Let's say I want to study the effect of types of food on the weight increase of an animal. Okay, what are the experimental units and what are the treatment? Okay. So here, can you answer me? Yeah, you want to study the impact of types of food, yeah, on the weight increase of an animal. Let's say the animal is ready. So what are the experimental units?
Rabbits,
right? Yeah. So what are the treatment? The types of food, right? Can be type A, type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4, right? So that is the experimental units and also treatment. How about if I want to study the effect of types of fertilizer on yield of a crop? On yield of crop. What are the treatment? Yeah. Type of fertilizer, right? What are the experimental units? Will it be the crop? Because you see, experimental units, entities such as person, animal, object, or anything that receive the treatment. Or we will apply that treatment to that entity. Yeah. So will you apply the fertilizer on the crop? Yeah.
On the soil.
The soil. Yeah. So meaning that the plot of land or the soil will be the experimental units. Okay. You will apply the treatment to that entity, not to the crop. Yeah, so it's very important that you understand what is the experimental units and also the treatment. Okay. So now I want to define experimental and observational studies. Yeah. So it's very important to understand that analysis of variance are useful for both
experimental and observational studies. Yeah. For experimental studies, what is experimental studies? Yeah. The independent of variable, the independent variable of interest or the factor are under the control of the experimenter. When I say that the independent variable of interest or the under the control of the experimenter, meaning that the researcher will assign the treatment to the experimental units. Yeah, so you will assign. Yeah, you will, the factor levels are assigned at random to the experimental units. How is the randomization is done? I will discuss afterwards. Okay. Observational studies. Yeah. So the independent variable of interest are not under the control of the experimenter. Yeah, it's the opposite. Not under the control. Yeah. So when, so how I'm going to get my data? The data were obtained without controlling the independent variable of interest. Meaning that no randomization is done here. You do not randomize the treatment to the experimental units. Yeah? Rather than you select, random sample are obtained from two or more population. Yeah? You mean you select a random sample from each of the population, like the example that I have given you earlier this morning, Yeah? So you, it's very important. Yeah? If no randomization is done, meaning that the treatment are not assigned to the experimental unit, meaning that this is observational studies. So it's very important that you plan your study before you collect your data to determine whether you want to use experimental or observational studies. Yeah. So after this one I will mention afterwards. Look at this example. Yeah. A study of the effect of educational background. Let's say I want to study the effect of educational background and types of experience of salesmen on sales volume of a particular product. Okay, so here what we have here now,
we have how many factors that I have in this example? How many factors? Two, right? Types of educational background and also types of experience. So you will have types of educational background here and types of experience. Type of experience, you have two. Yeah?
So here, if you look at this example, a random sample of salesmen. Yeah? So what is the experimental unit here? The salesmen. Yeah? A random sample of salesmen currently employed by the company and obtaining information on their highest degree obtained. So let's say, so what I do, I collect salesmen, my questionnaire or what. So I classify this background one, perhaps a bachelor degree or master, PhD and so on. Yeah. So here, types of experience, 1 year experience, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year and so on. Yeah. So what I do, I select the salesman through questionnaire. Yeah, to get the data, then I classify here. Yeah, let's say here for each of these, let's say 4 or 5 here, how many sales that they make. Yeah, so meaning that here in this example, this is not experimental studies where I do not assign the treatment. What are the treatment? The combination of educational background and types of experience. Yeah, I do not assign those treatment to the salesmen. Rather that each of the salesmen have their own characteristic. Yeah? Alright? So this is very important to understand that this kind of studies is what we call this observational studies. Well, of course, you will have experimental and classification factors. Yeah? Where classification factor based on observational studies and experimental factor based on experimental studies. So it's very important. First, you have to know how to differentiate between observational and experimental studies. Okay. Now, so here, see, I have to give you more explanation because most of you do not have a basic, right? Do not have basic in experimental design. Yeah. So to do this, I think you
increase of wetness reading of white cotton cloth. Okay, let's say that is your objective. Yeah. So how many so here you have detergent A, B, C, D. Okay, let's say you have 4 types of detergent and you want to study their effect on the whiteness reading of white cotton cloth. If you want to see the effect of this, of course you need to do, you conduct an experiment. Yeah, because you want to see the effect of this detergent on the whiteness reading of white cotton cloth. You need to wash. So you need to have experimental units. You have to plan. You need to have experimental units. What are the experimental units? Sample white cotton cloth, isn't it? So you need to have those. So you will have sample white cotton cloth. This is just a simple explanation. So you will have this. You get ready with that. Then since you want to see the effect of this detergent, you need to contaminate. First contaminate this. So you contaminate with grease or with tomato. So you contaminate. If you have contaminated them, then of course you can see their effect, the effect of each of these, whether they are different or they are not different. So let's say, let's say when you conduct your experiment, you wash this screen with detergent A, this with detergent B, and so on. Once you have washed this, so at the end of the study, you want to measure, isn't it? You want to measure the what we call this, the whiteness reading, right? Because you want to see the effect. So at the end of the study, after washing them, you measure the whiteness reading that you call, you denote as YIJ, the whiteness reading of this white cotton cloth. And then you test your hypothesis. Actually, we have not we have not come to the way how to test the hypothesis and so on. This is still introduction. So let's say you you state your hypothesis H naught, mu 1 equal to mu 2, mu 3, mu 4. Because you have 4 detergent, 4 treatment, H1, at least one of these are not equal. Okay, so once you do that, let's say you test your hypothesis, this after what I will mention to you how to derive this statistic. So after you test this hypothesis, at the end of the study, you conclude. Let's say based on the statistical test, the analysis that you have done, the conclusion is reject H0. When you reject H0, meaning there is a significant difference among the 4 types of detergent on the whiteness reading of white cotton cloth. So when you present this, result, perhaps some of you, some of the audience think that the result, the conclusion cannot be trusted. The result cannot be trusted. Why? So of all we know, the white cotton cloth that has been washed using detergent A has been less contaminated. Has been less contaminated than the rest, isn't it? You less contaminated. Here, you put a lot of grease, but here less. Of course, of course there is a difference. What else that you can think of? Perhaps this this here, this 3 white cotton cloth, that washed by B has been you have used more time to clean, right? Meaning that of course there will be difference if you use different time. What else that you can think of? Perhaps the last two the last 6 sample white cotton cloth that is washed by detergent C and D has used different temperature level. Of course, there will be differences in their effect. Here I just want to mention, the conclusion is only possible, only can be trusted if the differences is only due to the quality of the detergent. Okay, but we have seen, that there are many other factors that will affect the experimental result. Okay? So, in general,
Yeah, here I just want to highlight. In general, if I want to show one factor, yeah, one factor is the cause of the differences. What is that one factor? Different types of detergent, right? We must make sure that there are no other factors that will be held responsible for them. Yeah? So, but we have seen that there are many other factors that will affect the experimental result. Yeah? So in this situation, if this is the situation, so how to protect all these factors, yeah? How to protect this, how to avoid other factors, that we call it extraneous or nuisance factors that will affect our experimental result. How to, how to protect this, how to avoid this from happening. Yeah? There are two ways to do this. Number one, by using control experiment. Yeah? When I say control experiment, meaning that all variables except the one of concern, yeah, is held fixed. Yeah? Meaning that the one of concern is the types of detergent. Other factors, I will have to help fix. Meaning that I must contaminate equally these other factors, right? And what else? The time taken must be, the time used to wash must be the same. Temperature levels must be the same. And all other factors must be same, reasonably same. Okay? So, but if, because after all we are human being, we cannot get that perfect experiment. Right? We cannot have perfect experiment, yeah? We try our best to contaminate the sample of white cotton cloth. Yeah? Because we are human beings, we do not know that we have given a bit more here than the rest. Right? And we try our best to wash the same time, but perhaps we have washed more for one than the other, more time taken, just a little bit. Yeah. So if there is still variation, meaning that if you cannot completely eliminate this source of variation, so we need to do randomization process. That's why here, in each of the experiments, we always have to do randomization. Yeah? So when I say randomization, meaning that the treatment are assigned at random to the experimental units. Yeah? That's why in any of the experiments in a design or anything statistical analysis, we need to randomize or we need to select random. We have to assign the treatment at random to the experimental unit. Why? Because randomization tends to eliminate the influence of these extraneous factors, yeah, from affecting the result of the experiment. Yeah?
In terms of randomization, how random does it get? Because I think there are three different types of random.
That one will be mentioned later. Afterwards, I will say. This is just still introduction. Huh? Okay? Yeah. This is so that you get the insight. Why this? Why that? Yeah? Later on, I will discuss. Yeah? Okay, now just to highlight, there are two aspects to any experimental problem. Number one, design of the experiment. Yeah? The design, you have to plan to have the correct design of analysis of experiment. And then this statistical analysis of data depend. If you choose, let's say, one design, the analysis will depend on that design. Meaning that if you have chosen wrong design, the analysis will be wrong. Then everything, all the conclusion will be wrong.